God, my hands are trembling. I gotta keep my act together. At least for now.
Yes, Jill. A body was found here on this patch of wasteland early this morning. The police are still searching the scene and questioning anyone who might have seen something, but no information has filtered through yet concerning the identity of the victim. Of course, everyone's wondering if the body is that of Jeremy Bowles and has the Oregon killer.
I noted that name somewhere. What was it? Blake. Lieutenant Carter Blake. Yeah, that's it. Reporters. Already. Huh. You seem well informed. Goddamn rain. Hasn't stopped pouring since I arrived. I'm really gonna love it here.
The zone is sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks. Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m. Related to the investigation.
The body must be under the tarp near the lights. I've got to find Lieutenant Carter Blake. The crime scene is compromised by all these people. I doubt there'll be many clues left, if there were any to start with. Way too many people here. They're trampling all over the crime scene. There's a railroad track near where the body was left. Same as all the other victims.
Lieutenant Blake? I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning. They told me you'd be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, can you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Coming, Jaden?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found the body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today. Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Do we know the cause of death?
There are no marks on the body. Chances are he was drowned, like the others.
Has the time of death been established?
Based on the rigor mortis, must be less than 6 hours ago. We should know more once the coroner has had a look.
Any witnesses?
None yet. Given the neighborhood, I'd be surprised if anybody saw anything. Tony, I don't want to see a single shit-stirring journalist within a mile of here. You got it?
Yes, Lieutenant.
Do you have any leads?
My men are going over the scene with a fine-tooth comb. If the killer left anything behind, we'll find it.
I know investigators never like to see FBI profilers turning up, but I'm here to help, if I can.
The only thing I'm interested in is finding the killer. I don't have an ego problem, if that's any reassurance. Listen, I'm a little busy here. Why don't we discuss all this a little later, back at the office?
Oh, no problem. I understand. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden, you come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Sample of no interest. It comes from one of the policemen present on the waste run. Some orchid pollen. The concentration of pollen in the air is quickly decreasing because of the rain, but it gets higher in the direction of the body.
Harry, comment. Sample of no interest. Comes from one of the policemen present on the wasteland. Harry, comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence. An orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. Superficial wound on the right thigh. Blood analysis suggests it could be post-mortem. Probably a scratch that occurred when the body was being moved. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims.
footprints continue just after the pollen trail. There's a good chance that they're the killers. Mary Comet, there are traces of blood on the fence behind the railroad line. It comes from the victim. The killer came this way with the body and probably grazed it on his way through the fence. There's a good chance that they're the killers. Harry, comment. Tire tracks on the side of the road behind the railroad line. Or maybe the killer's car.
I think I've seen all there is to see.
Comet, traces of blood on the railroad track. Analysis confirms it comes from the victim. Dead cat. The FBI doesn't keep files on dead cats. Not yet. I think I've seen enough. Better get back to the station before I catch pneumonia.
I'm heading back to the office. You staying?
No, I've seen enough. I'm leaving too.
A bat. A fox. A crab. Death. Death.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition. I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
It was an accident. Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death. How is Sean?
I know he's really unhappy. He just can't understand why I seem unable to love him.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
I stopped living at the same time Jason did. And that car ran into us.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times when I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later, but I'm someplace else. And I have no idea how I got there. Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months. We really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain. That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week. You were lucky, Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor. You want to eat something? Aren't you going to go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
How did things go at school today?
The teacher yelled at me for being late again. She's going to send me home the next time it happens.
I'm sorry about that, Sean. Next time, we'll really pull it together, okay? Is something the matter, Sean?
No, I'm all right.
Sean used to love going to the park, laughing and messing around. Man, he was so happy. But that was before, with Jason. We're just not communicating. Feels like we're drifting apart. What am I going to do to cheer him up? Saw a boomerang in his bag. He used to be pretty good with one of those.
A boomerang? You know how to use it?
No, not really. I can never make it come back.
Can I give it a try?
You did it, Dad.
Do you want to give it a try?
I won't be able to do it.
Oh, come on, let's try together. Now, the main thing is to get the right position at the beginning. Now, you got to throw it straight and a little to the right. Now, throw it!
I did it, Dad!
Good job, Sean. See? That wasn't so hard.
Sean used to love playing on the seesaw. I'll find something else to do with him. Maybe a ride on the merry-go-round. Maybe he'd like to have a turn on the swings. Sean used to love playing on the seesaw.
I haven't been on a seesaw in a long time. What do you think?
Yeah! Come on, Dad, make me fly!
I'll find something else to do with him.
You want to go play on the swing? I'll push you.
Okay. That was cool.
Looks like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay. You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, Sean. Me too.
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel? Can I?
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket.
Sean looks happy. I wish I could see him like that more often.
One, please.
That's a dollar.
I want to get back to being the kind of father I used to be.
Son! Son! Son!